The Drama of American History, The Civil War, 1860 to 1865, by Christopher Collier and James Lincoln Collier, narrated by Jim Manchester. Preface. Over many years of both teaching and writing for students at all levels, from grammar school to graduate school, it has been borne in on us that many, if not most, American history textbooks suffer from trying to include everything of any moment in the history of the nation. Students become lost in a swamp of factual information, and as a consequence, lose track of how those facts fit together and why they are significant and relevant to the world today. In this series, our effort has been to strip the vast amount of available detail down to a central core. Our aim is to draw in bold strokes, providing enough information, but no more than is necessary, to bring out the basic themes of the American story and what they mean to us now. We believe that it is surely more important for students to grasp the underlying concepts and ideas that emerge from the movement of history, than to memorize an array of facts and figures. The difference between this series and many standard texts lies in what has been left out. We are convinced that students will better remember the important themes if they are not buried under a heap of names, dates, and places. In this sense, our primary goal is what might be called citizenship education. We think it is critically important for America as a nation and Americans as individuals to understand the origins and workings of the public institutions which are central to American society. We have asked ourselves again and again what is most important for citizens of our democracy to know so that they can most effectively make the system work for themselves and the nation. For this reason, we have focused on political and institutional history, leaving social and cultural history less well developed. This series is divided into volumes that move chronologically through the American story. Each is built around a single topic, such as the Pilgrims, the Constitutional Convention, or immigration. Each volume has been written so that it can stand alone for students who wish to research a given topic. As a consequence, in many cases, material from previous volumes is repeated, usually in abbreviated form, to set the topic in its historical context. That is to say, students of the Constitutional Convention must be given some idea of relations with England and why the Revolution was fought, even though the material was covered in detail in a previous volume. Readers should find that each volume tells an entire story that can be read with or without reference to other volumes. Despite our belief that it is of the first importance to outline sharply basic concepts and generalizations, we have not neglected the great dramas of American history. The stories that will hold the attention of students are here, and we believe they will help the concepts they illustrate to stick in their minds. We think, for example, that knowing of Abraham Baldwin's brave and dramatic decision to vote with the small states at the Constitutional Convention will bring alive the Connecticut Compromise, out of which grew the American Senate. Each of these volumes has been read by esteemed specialists in its particular topic. We have benefited from their comments. Chapter 1. The Coming of the War. The Civil War was one of the greatest dramas in American history. A story so filled with blood, glory, terror, and triumph that it has been the subject of over 50,000 serious books in English. Not just Americans, but people all around the world have been fascinated by it. The idea of brother against brother has always been compelling. The Civil War split Americans in many cases dividing families so that brothers, fathers, and sons fought on opposite sides. Senator John Crittenden of Kentucky had one son a general in the Confederate Army, another a general in the Union Army.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.